First thing you need to do before starting this course is to set up your lab. And because this is an ethical hacking course and all the skills that you're going to learn during this course is hacking, so this need to be done in a lab. You should not try the skills that you're going to learn during this course on real people or on real application or website. It's very, very important. We deliver this course just to get the skills to be able to test people's system after taking their approval. But you should not randomly try that because this is illegal and it may cause you trouble. Now, what exactly do I know? What exactly do I need to set up my lab? We're going to need the following. Number one, I'm going to need a VMware player. And VMware, for people who didn't use VMware before, this is a virtualization product. It allows you to create many virtual machines on your computer. And by doing that, you're going to have different computer with different platform, with different service, and you can try to hack from one to another. And VMware has a license, it's not free, but VMware Player, it's free. Then we're going to need Linux, different distribution from Linux. And I usually use three. Kali Linux, Backtrack, and GNACTrack. And they are quite similar, except sometimes I prefer to use GNACTrack or Backtrack or Kali Linux, but most of the commands that I'm going to use exist on the 3 edition. And it's good to download the 3 of them to be familiar. And if you don't have experience with Linux, don't worry. We have a specific section. Actually, it will be the next section where I'm going to explain Linux from scratch. Because you need to learn how to use Linux. You don't need to get about Linux architecture or about, you just need to learn the same way you are using Windows. A lot of people are using Windows, but they are not aware of the architecture of the operating system. Same idea with Linux. You know, to know how to use Linux and how to get familiar with Linux. And we're gonna take a section for people who do not have any background with Linux. Then we're gonna need some Windows operating system. I prefer that you get Windows XP and 7 and 2003, and I recommend that you start with XP because it's full of vulnerable. And once you get confidence, once you get a lot of practicing, then you can move on to 7 and higher version. You need to have from Windows an client edition, could be 7 XP and 7 or 8. And a server edition like 2003 or 2008 or 2012. So that what will be needed. Now I need to show you how to download those, and I'm gonna add with this video the link from where you can download. So let's start with the VMware player. So you just need to Google it, you don't need to memorize any website, just click on or type download VMware player. And as I told you, Player is free, and the Linux is free, and even Windows. I'm going to show you that Microsoft can give you the Windows operating system for free for 180 days. So you don't have to worry about that. So you can go to VMware Player, and you're going to find that there is a tab for downloading VMware Player. So I'll add all the link, so don't worry about that. But I just want you to write down what exactly will be needed. So we're going to start with the VMware player. And I don't know why it's taking so long. I already downloaded. Just want to show you the website. This is a VMware player. But let me wait until it loads. And we're going to download everything right now. And then later on, or on the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up the image inside VMware and to be able to run more than one machine on your computer. So this is the website from VMware, from where you can download the VMware player, and it's completely free and you can download it. And I believe you're going to find that very, very effective because it's a very powerful tool. So once you download that, then we need to download what is remaining. So for Linux, same idea. You type download Kali Linux and Kali Linux. It's from a company called Offensive Security. Kali and backtrack, and you click here, and it's straightforward. You don't need to do anything about the download, just downloading the regular program, and it has a lot of documentation. So you go and you check which platform you have, 64-bit or 32, and I hope you know how to verify that. You just right click on my computer and you check system, and it will tell you if it's 64 or 32. So you download the one needed for your machine. And in Kali Linux there is a hash. Actually, later on during this course you're going to understand what is this hash. It has nothing to do with the program. It's just a way for verifying that this program has not been modified. So don't worry about the hash, just download the right one and make sure to download the ISO image. Same concept for the backtrack, because backtrack from the same company. So you go and you download the backtrack as well. So backtrack, and go to the link, and same idea, just check what operating system do you have, and I mean 64 or 32-bit platform, and decide based on that. And finally, the GNAC track. GNAC track. And this is also, GNAC track. And you're going to find the link here, and you can download it as well. So this is the first step that you need to do. It's to download them and put them inside the folder. Make sure that the image, it's downloaded, all the image that we're going to download, ISO image, and install them inside the folder the same way I did. I have here all the ISO image, backtrack and Kali Linux and gtrack and everything. Then regarding downloading Windows, as I told you, you don't need to get anything cracked. Microsoft will offer you their product. Actually, they do that with all their products. They give you 180-day free trial version, and after that, if you want to keep the software, you need to pay for the license. Otherwise, you can just delete them. So no commitment or that. So for instance, if we need to download Windows 8 trial, you're gonna find, or 7, you will find that from Microsoft website, you can go and you can download the free trial. So as I told you, you need to get an old version and a new version. So we need, definitely we need Windows XP, and then a higher, 7 or 8. And on the server, we need Windows Server 2003 and something higher, 2008 or 12. So you need to have an old version and a new version as well. So repeat that for the same step for Microsoft Windows. And I'm sorry about the lateness, I don't know what, but actually I was doing some denial of service on my router, so I think it get infected. So, okay, so this is how it should be done. And on the next video, once you download them, I'm going to show you how to set up your lab. So I believe after finishing this video, before starting the first one, go and download all the required software, and then on the next video, just follow me step by step. I'll show you how to set up your lab. So this is Microsoft evaluation Windows. I think you usually need to register for free in their Technet website, in their website here, and then they'll allow you to download that, and you'll be able to use it for 180 days. So thank you, and on the next video I'm going to show you how to set up that.